Freedom is not just a term that we use on the 4th of July. Freedom is not just a buzzword that you throw into a speech to make people like you, and freedom is not even the self-destructive intake of calories that far exceed the needs of your body that leads to a myocardial infarction and premature death. Freedom is whatever you want it to be, because that's why it's called freedom. But when it comes to games, few can match the levels of freedom found in Ghost Recon Future Soldier. Like, you know when a game gives you an intelligent metal dog called the Warhound that has an unlimited supply of artillery shells and predator missiles, it knows what freedom is.
Friendly predator missile incoming.
And speaking of predator missiles, one of the main characters in the game is that voice actor from Modern Warfare 2. Like, you guys remember this guy, right?
Rangers, lead the way.
Not only is he in the game, but also the voice actor from Toonami.
Officer Sykes is on his way to Ramstein Air Base. After they check him out, he'll be going home, thanks to you.
And I know that none of you know what Toonami is because you're too young, but just take my word for it, you missed out. Now this game, in a nutshell, is essentially cookie-cutter third-person shooter plus...
So is it any wonder people are afraid of technology?
Technology!
But I must say, I have never played something so tactical in my entire life. We're not just talking, I crouch walk too often, tactical. We're talking, I am literally wearing full kit underneath an invisibility cloak in the dark with night vision goggles on my face in the prone position while barrel rolling. Tactical. Like, this game is so tactical, even airsofters think it's too much.
Hey bro, it's Milson.
Shut the f-
The best part of the game is that you can play it however you want to in most cases. If you want to down some low-carb monster, take off your suppressor and blaze through enemy lines while listening to Green Day and Skrillex at the same time, you can do that. Go Skrillex, rabbit horse. You're also welcome to take the opposite approach and live up to your name of Ghost. And with features like the body cradle and melee takedown, you can have as much of a mix between aggression and stealth as you want. One aspect that I love is how they cut out all of the Hollywood operator hogwash, where they try to only kill enemies when it's absolutely necessary, because the ghosts don't spare anybody. Like, if you accidentally were talking on your cell phone in the wrong part of town...
Surprise, motherfucker!
But still, the environments are really what I enjoy about this game. It's not just random map set in the Middle East or Eastern Europe number 548, but a wide variety of countries and settings, including cities, forests, the Arctic, even the deserts of Africa, which is a great change of pace. The only annoyance about this is that Ubisoft tries to make every cutscene with this nature background into some kind of dramatic sequence that incorporates the characters and the environment into some kind of cinematic highlight reel that takes itself way too seriously. Now, although the graphics aren't...
Hey man, what are you playing?
Ghost Recon, why didn't you knock?
Are you in the desert?
Yes, I happen to be in the desert.
You know what happens in the desert, right?
What happens in the desert? It's just sand.
You know what happens when it gets windy in the desert, right?
When it gets windy in the desert, what? No.
I think as as the game goes on, you start to realize how much your entire squad is basically cheating. Like, not only do you have a grenade that you can throw that 3D spots every person within its radius, marking them red, but you also have X-ray vision where you can see through essentially everything. It's almost as if the government of the United States just said, how can we possibly cheese the enemies of this country as much as possible? And they gave you all of the gear to do so. This most definitely includes the UAV. With this thing, you can simply toss it up in the air like it's a hacky sack, spot enemies with Q, and have your squad execute them simultaneously for triple kills without even pulling the trigger.
Triple kill!
Of course, you can join in on the fun for a perfectly timed four-piece, but I think you get the idea. The odds are heavily stacked in your favor.
On your word.
But I guess that's somehow balanced out by the number of random explosions in the game, and these aren't just average explosions. These are massive explosions.
What the hell?
Get out of there!
Move! Get clear! Get clear! Move!
What the fuck?
And you would not believe how melodramatic they make the sequences following these explosions or any death-oriented scene in general. It's so awkward.
I gotta testify. Come up in the spot looking extra fly. For the day I die, I'ma touch the sky. Gotta testify. Come up in the spot looking extra fly. For the day I die, I'ma touch the sky.
That's not to say that the dialogue isn't halfway clever. I mean, it's not hilarious, but it makes you say,
"All right, ha ha ha."
Like in one instance, when taking an elevator, they say, "At least it's not stairs."
At least it's not stairs.
And then in the later mission, you have to hike up 15 flights of stairs. That, my friends, is a literary device called foreshadowing, something that would have been a lot funnier in the form of a cutscene, because actually forcing me to run up 15 flights of stairs is pretty stupid boring. Feature that is just laughable is the nonsense of "please stand next to this character in order to complete the mission" type nonsense. As in, if you don't stand in one specific spot to trigger a cutscene, you will be fighting a perpetual wave of enemies, like the supply of adversaries is endless.
Well,
reason why I speed ran the game, smacked the Russian general in the face, and left the bureaucrat to get hit by that train.
Sounds like your ride's coming.
Okay, it's childish Gambino, homegirl dropping like the NASDAQ. Move white girls like this coke up my ass crack. Move black girls, cause man, fuck it, I'll do either. I love pussy, I love bitches, dude, I should be running Peter in Adidas with some short shorts. B-O-O all over me, my queen is where it's supposed to be.
Oh yeah, and you wanna know why Russia doesn't have freedom? Because they don't have free refills. Checkmate, Soviets.